Warriors, this is your favorite VP, Dr. V, with a message from the heart this morning. The month of February is dedicated to Black History Month. As a student like you, I recall only learning about Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., Rosa Parks, and occasionally Malcolm X. What we fail to discuss, however, is the role that children, yes, middle school and high school age children played in fighting for and often dying for social justice in this country. Children like Emmett Till, Ruby Bridges, and the four little girls, Addie Mae Collins, Cynthia Wesley, Carol Robertson, and Denise McNair, ages 9 through 12, who were killed in a church bombing in Alabama. So when I think of Black History Month and the legacy of children, yes, children like you and children like my 8-year-old daughter Trinity and my 4-year-old son Tyson, I think about the urgency of now. In 1938, nearly 77 years ago, Langston Hughes wrote the poem that we will discuss today, Kids Who Die. In planning this lesson, I recognize that some of us may be uncomfortable opening up ourselves to discussing Black history and this Langston Hughes poem. But I encourage you to speak, even if your voice shakes. As we listen to this poem, again, written in 1938, I want you to reflect on the relevance of this poem in 2021. Most importantly, I want you to write in the chat or discuss aloud. Keep in mind, even if your voice shakes, one thing you can do to better heal and shape our country so children like your classmates, children like my children, and your future children and their children can live peacefully without worrying about the consequences associated.
This is for the kids who die, Black and white. For kids will die certainly. The old and the rich will live on a while, as always, eating blood and gold, letting kids die. Kids will die in the swamps of Mississippi, organizing sharecroppers. Kids will die in the streets of Chicago, organizing workers. Kids will die in the orange groves of California, telling others to get together. Whites and Filipinos, Negroes and Mexicans, all kinds of kids will die who don't believe in lies and bribes and contentment and a lousy peace. Of course, the wise and the learned who pen editorials in the papers will live on weaving words to smother the kids who die. And the sleazy courts, and the bribe-reaching police, and the blood-loving generals, and the money-loving preachers will all raise their hands against the kids who die, beating them with laws and clubs and bayonets and bullets to frighten the people. For the kids who die are like iron in the blood of the people. Listen, kids who die. Maybe now there will be no monument for you, except in our hearts. But the day will come. You assure yourself that it is coming, when the marching feet of the masses will raise for you a living monument of love and joy and laughter. and black hands and white hands clasped as one, and a song that reaches the sky, the song of the life triumphant through the kids who die.
And that was a lot to process. I know that it was a lot to see. And as a Black woman, as a mother, as a school leader, it hurts to see these images. And it hurts to hear this poem in 1938 and see how it resonates in 2021. But again, I want you to write in the chat right now or discuss aloud one thing that you can do to better heal and shape our country so children like your classmates, my children, and your future children can live peacefully. So in this moment, as you're gathering your thoughts, one thing that I'm committed to doing personally at West Campus specifically is to just have honest conversations with all of you about race, class, sexism, ageism, whatever the topic is. I want us as a school community and you as high school students to feel confident and safe to have these hard conversations. And so I'm open to having a platform, a forum, I don't know what it looks like virtually, but that's my commitment so that we can all come together and discuss these topics in a safe space. So what is one thing you're willing to do? Go ahead and write in the chat or discuss aloud. And teachers, I thank you for your time. And West Campus Warriors, I thank you for having a courageous conversation today. And I just hope that, again, that we all commit to doing just one thing to make this world a better place, especially through the lens of Black History Month. Thank you again.